Om. ஸ்ரீகுருப்போ நம. ஹரி ஓம். சதாசிவசமாரம்பாம் சங்கராச்சாரியமத்யமாம் அஸ்மதாச்சாரியபர்யந்தாம் வந்தே குருபரம்பராம் ஸ்ருதிஸ்மிருதிபுராணானாம் ஆலயம் கருணாலயம் நமாமி பகவத்பாத சங்கரம் லோகசங்கரம் சங்கரம் சங்கராச்சாரியம் கேசவம் பாதராயணம் சூத்திரபாஷ்யகிருதௌ வந்தே பகவந்தௌ புனப்புன ஈஸ்வரோ குருராத்மேதி மூர்த்திபேதவிபாகினே வோமவத்வியாப்ததேஹாய தக்ஷிணாமூர்த்தயே நம. உகாரஸ்வந்தகாரோ வை சுகாரஸ்தன்னிவர்த்தகா அந்தகார நிரோதித்வாத் குருவித்யபிதீயதே. ஓம் சஹனாபவது சஹனௌபுனக்து சஹவீர்யங்கரவாவஹை தேஜஸ்வினாவதீதமஸ்து மா வித்விஷாவஹை. ஓம் சாந்தி ஷாந்தி ஷாந்திஹி. ஓம் ப்ரஹ்மவிதா ஆப்னோதி பரம் ததேஷாப்யுக்தா சத்யம் ஞானமனந்தம் ப்ரஹ்மா யோ வேத நிஹிதம் குஹாயாம் பரமே வ்யோமன் சோஷ்ணுதே சர்வான் காமான் சஹா ப்ரஹ்மணா விபஸ்சிதேதி. அசத்ேதி வேதச்சேத் அஸ்திரேதி சேத்வேத சந்தமேனந்தோபிதுரிதி தைஷயேபாரீர ஆத்மா யூர்வச. குத்துன ஆசங்கா தன்னாஸ்தித்வே. Bhashyakara raised this question: why is Brahman nasti iti ashanka? Why is there a doubt whether Brahman exists or it doesn't? What is the reason for this kind of a doubt? Is a question he asks. For that, because the shastra's line is asanevasa bhavati asti asat brahmeti vedachet. If somebody takes Brahman as non-existent, so what is the reason for this kind of a doubt? Vyavahara atitatvam brahmanaha iti brumaha. So he answers saying because it is vyavahara atitam. So yadyad vyavahara atitam tattate asat. வியவஹார அதீதத்வாத் யதா வந்தியாபுத்திரவத் ஆர் ரஜ்ஜு சர்ப்பவத் இஸ் எ நியாய தட் தீஸ் பீப்புள் யூஸ். வாட் டஸ் இட் மீன்? வாட் எவர் இஸ் நாட் அவைலபிள் ஃபார் வியவஹாரா தட் இஸ் நான் எக்ஸிஸ்டன்ட், ஜஸ்ட் லைக் அ ரோப் ஸ்னேக். ஸோ இன் த வேர்ல்ட் தெர் ஆர் டூ டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் existence and non-existence. So satyam and tucham is what people talk about, like a rabbit horn does not exist, or a rope snake, a snake superimposed on rope does not exist. It's called atyanta sat, eternally non-existent. You will never find a rabbit's horn. that is tucham, non-existent. And then there is satyam, a rabbit is satyam, rabbit's horn is tucham, because it is not available for vyavahara. So whatever is not available for vyavahara does not exist. But we say the rabbit itself is mithya. So we introduce this new term, mithya. Pot is mithya and clay is satyam. What is satyam and what is mithya? Mithya is a dependent reality. So a dependent reality, unlike an empirical, in the empirical world there is a tucham, this has a new state which is different from satyam and asat, which is mithya, that is called sadasadbhyam anirvachaniyam mithya. It is indeterminable between whether it is sat or asat. Therefore, this vyavahara atitattvam is not a criteria in determining something is satyam, because what is, in fact, we say yadyat vyavahara anatitam tattat mithya. So whatever is available for vyavahara, that those are mithya, because they have attributes. So what is available for vyavahara? This cloth is available for vyavahara. What is the cloth? Today I say this is cloth. So is every yarn, every fiber a cloth, every tissue a cloth? Yeah, yarn is cloth. Okay, then what is this yarn? Yarn is fibers. Okay, then what is fiber? It is nothing but atoms and molecules. Then what is molecule? It is particle. And then it is energy. What is energy? So we keep going. It is a dependent, each one of them is a dependent reality. It's not an independent reality. Anything you take for that matter within vyavahara, within the realm of experience, any object which is available for perception or inference is a dependent reality only. So even whatever is vyavahara siddham, available for vyavahara, that is mithya. That is not satyam, because they are all dependent reality. So what is independent reality? It ends at Brahman only. But here the question is, why Brahman is doubted for its existence? Because whatever is vyavahara atitam, it is considered as non-existent. Vyavahara, so therefore Brahman's existence is doubted. Vyavahara vishayehi vacharambana matre astitva bhavita buddhihi. The mind is conditioned to see only vyavahara vishaya, which is vakalambanam, which has name and form. Everything that is having name and form, the mind is conditioned to see that as asti, this exists. So So when only if I am able to perceive an attribute, then my mind accepts that it exists. So I need to see a color, so or a form, or a shape, or a smell, or I should be able to touch it. So it should be available for my indriya, or it should be described to me in the form of what is available for my indriyas. For example, somebody describes to me a kamadhenu. Kamadhenu looks like this. It is like a cow. It has a wing. It has a human kind of head. And then it gives, you know, whatever you wish. Like that, there is some a kind of cow which exists in Swarga. Suppose somebody tells me. So it is not available to me in Pratyaksha and all that, but it is still perceivable for me because it is defined in terms of certain attributes. So when the attributes, the guna, the rupa and guna, are the ways for me to identify objects. Even when microscopically, when something is looked at and somebody describes it, anything, a scientist describes something, that description will always be in forms of certain attributes. And those attributes which are namarupa, that is called vakalambanam, vacharambanam, because every word, the word actually ends in an attribute or an object that gives me knowledge of it. Or if I see, it is still a vakalambana. This is a tree and this is how it looks. And then that is the tree perception. Therefore, vacharambana matre astitva bhavita buddhihi. The mind is conditioned to look at things which are in name and form only. Tadviparite vyavahara atite nastitvamapi pratipadyate. And I say something doesn't exist. The buddhi thinks something doesn't exist based on it is non-available for vyavahara. So rabbit's horn, like we said, is not available for vyavahara. Therefore, it doesn't exist. Yata ghatati ghatadihi vyavahara. So he gives an example. Ghatadihi vyavahara vishayataya upapannaha sanne tadviparitaha asan iti prasiddham. Simply takes a ghata, a pot that was available for vyavahara. Now it is broken, it is gone, whatever. It is not available for vyavahara. So therefore it is asat. Asangataha, non-existence of pot. So it was there because it was available for vyavahara. Now it is not there. Therefore the absence of pot exists. Is how we look at things. So pot extends to anything, correct? So something which was available for vyavahara only at some point, now you say that it doesn't exist. If I tell you Gagabugan doesn't exist, then you will question, what is Gagabugan? Then I need to tell some attributes to say that this is Gagabugan and it doesn't exist. So the vyavahara vishaya has to be first said what it is, and then only I can say it doesn't exist. So here this Brahman, there is no attribute. So this asti nasti ashanka, where does it come from? Because you have to define it in terms of attribute first to say what is Brahman. Then only the negation is possible. So here there is no, it is not available for vyavahara. Therefore, it is like a gagabaga only. Right? So, evam tat samanyat iha api syat brahmanaha nastitvam prati ashanka. Tasmaduchyate asti brahmeti ched veda. It's an object which is not available for vivahara. Therefore, the doubt of whether you are talking about some Brahman, is there something called Brahman, which you say is sarvavyapi, whatever. So that kind of a doubt is tenable. Is the question. Now, if somebody doubts, then what happens is how he starts the answer. The Shastra answers, Kim punaha syat tadasti iti vijanataha. If somebody knows that it exists, vijanati, then what happens? Tadaha santam vidyamanam brahmasvarupena paramartha sadatma apannam yenam evam vidam viduhu brahma vidaha tataha tasmad astitva vedanat saha anyesham brahma vid vigneyah brahmavad vigneyah bhavati ityartha. So brahmavad vigneyah bhavati, the person who knows Brahman, he or she, himself or herself, vijñeyaha anyesham bhavati. For others, this person becomes another object of knowing. Very interestingly, Shastra equates a Brahmavid to Brahman itself. Brahmavid Brahmaiva bhavati. So, a person who knows Brahman, he or she is Brahman itself. I mean, even otherwise, everybody is Brahman. But the knower of Brahman gains the stature of Brahman itself, because the person's ego or the person's eye sense is no more limited to a body sense, mind sense complex. But the person locates the eye in Sarvavyapi Brahman. So the person becomes, you know, an altar of worship, an altar to be known. That's why a Brahmajnani Brahmajnam Pujayet Bhutikamaha. So when people, so there is a statement which says, right, that so when somebody wants any kind of blessings, let that person worship a Brahmajnani, a Brahmavit. So it is said in worldly parlance. But more importantly, a Jnani is somebody who needs to be understood, because by understood that person's vision, by understanding it, you can understand Brahman, because that person is Brahman, Brahman itself. Therefore, here Shastra says, Anyesham Brahmavite Brahmavat Vigneyaha Bhavati. Brahmavat Vigneya. He needs to be known as, just like how you want to know Brahman. Why? Astitva Vedanat. Because here Brahma Asti Iti Vedanat. When somebody knows Brahman exists, so he starts with Asti Brahma, but ends up with Asmi Brahma. There is no Asti Brahma. Asti Brahma, if you say there is something called Brahman exist, then he hasn't actually known it, correct? Because if everything is Brahman, it has to be known as Asmi Brahma, I am Brahman. So when that knowledge has taken place is when somebody is a Brahmavit. But here Shastra says, Asti Brahmet Ched Veda. Or since the journey starts with Asti Brahma and ends with Asmi Brahma, one can assume he is a potential Brahmavid, because he has Shraddha. He has a view that, yeah, there is a Brahman, and this is what Shastra says. Now I need to learn what is this Brahman. Then he becomes a Brahmavid by taking the pursuit. So a person who is in pursuit, a sadhaka, also can be an altar of worship. But ideally, we can understand that Shastra is talking about a Brahmavid here. Therefore, even though it is Asti Brahma, it only means Asmi Brahma. So therefore, let's see what the previous line is. Santam vidyamanam brahm. So santam yenam tato viduhu iti is the statement, is the Upanishad Vakya. So santam means, Subhashikara says, santam vidyamanam. So that which exists, brahmasvarupena, in the form of Brahman, this is Ittambhute Tritiya, in the form of Brahman, paramartha sadhe, sadhe atma apannam. So how is this person paramartha sadatma apannam, brahmasvarupena? So this person has gained this Svarūpa. What Svarūpa? Brahmasvarupa, which is paramartha sati. It is the ultimate reality. So that's how we can translate it, right? Paramartha sati atma apannam. So he has gained the ultimate reality. Everything else is asat. Why paramartha? Like we said, when I look at the cloth, it reduces to yarn. Yarn reduces to fibers, to tissues, to molecules, to atoms, to energy, to whatever, and finally it reduces to sat, which is Brahman, after which you can't further reduce it, because everything is available as attribute to what? That awareness, that consciousness, to which everything else is available for objectification, as though available, because what is sat, what is mithya, we have seen many times. Therefore, the paramartha sat is Brahman only. After that, you can't further reduce it. Therefore, paramartha sat atma apannam. That is the nature, that is the Svarūpa. That Svarūpa, Brahma Svarūpena, vidyamanam, evam vidam viduhu. In this form, a person who has known, he is a Brahma vidaha. So therefore there is no Asti Brahma. It is Asmi Brahma only. Because he clearly explains, Santam Vidyamanam Brahmasvarupena Paramartha Sadatma Apannam. So Sadatma Apannam Brahmasvarupena. Okay, and so this is only Atma Svarupa. Atma is Brahma, which is Paramartha Sadrupena, Brahmasvarupena, in the form of Paramartha Sad, in the form of oneself, and Brahma, Brihi Vriddhav. So that is Sarvavyapi. There is no end to it. It is beyond all dimensions. Every dimension is limited. So Brahman is unlimited because it is beyond dimension. Because all dimensions are also within the realm of Vyavahara. This is small, this is big, is within the realm of Vyavahara only. This is past, this is future, this is present. All that is Vyavahara only. So the time is within Vyavahara. Big and small is spatiality, is within Vyavahara. Objects are within Vyavahara. They are all Namarupa. Is it not? Something is big because of the attribute which is known to me, and it is within the concept of dimension, size, because it is known to me, so it is a Vyavaharam. So spatiality is within Vyavahara, time is within Vyavahara, objects are within Vyavahara. So they can't be Paramartha Sat. The Paramartha Sat is this, what is witnessing all this Vyavahara, that is beyond your Vyavahara. Therefore, that kind of a Brahma Svarupa, when a person recognizes, cognizes, it's not experience, because experience is also within Vyavahara. Any experience is within the realm of Vyavahara, because experience is always also of an attribute. Happiness, joy, anger, they're all experience. Emotions are experienced, forms are experienced, objects are experienced, all within Vyavahara only, because these are all also attributes. So the vyavahara atitam is Brahma, because then it's not only if it has attributes, it is an object which is spatially available, time-wise available, then we can say Brahma asti, that Brahman can be known and all that, and it is available for vyavahara. But this is a Brahman, it is not available for vyavahara. Means what? Not that it doesn't exist, but it is satyam. It is everything you see, any attribute you see, anything which is available for vyavahara resolves into this. Therefore, it is avyavaharyam. Purnam adaha, purnam idam. So, idam taya, whatever is available for this cognition is all that is available for vyavahara. So, that is purnam. And then what is adaha? What is not idam is adaha. Therefore, the only vastu which is not available for idantaya, this cognition, is I cognition. That I cognition, that I with reference to other things, is also individuality. We are not talking about that. But what is the adhishtana? That's why puchyam pratishta, Brahma puchyam pratishta. That which, on which even that I cognition and this cognition both take place, that is Brahman. So we are not talking about a deha vyatirikta atma, which is this individual. So everybody talks about soul. Even a Dvaitin, Visishta Dvaitin, or even other religions talk about soul, which is, you know, separate from the body and mind. So Vedanta, now in our sampradaya, what we don't talk about. Okay, of course, we in the within the empirical reality, we also talk about this jiva going out, attaining lokas and all that. But in the paramartha drishti, both this individual soul, whatever soul you want to talk, the jivatma, and the jagat are both supported or is resting on what reality? That is sadbrahma. Therefore, vidyamanam brahmasvarupena paramartha sadatma apannam. So this is the kind of recognition of what is Brahman. Evam vidam viduhu brahma vidaha. Pataha tasmat astitva vedanat saha anyesham brahmavati vijnayaha bhavati ityartaha. When somebody has this kind of a knowledge of everything is Brahman, then that person is Brahman only. Therefore, he becomes an altar of worship for others. Or not even here, it's not talking about altar of worship. In fact, Shastra Abhashikara says he needs to be known just like Brahman also, to be understood. So it's not about worshipping somebody or anything, but since someone wants to know what is Brahman, so through Shastra only you know Brahman, but this person, knowing this person also, you can understand what is Brahman, because that person is Brahman. That person's vision is Brahman vision and Shastric vision. Therefore, for one's own benefit, one can, because when one wants to understand what is Brahman, you understand this person. This person means this person's vision. Basically, it's a Shastra. So Shastra's vision is what this person's vision, so you learn it. Athava yaha nasti brahmeti manyate saha sarvasya eva sanmargasya varnashramadi vyavastha lakshanasya asraddhadanadaya nastitvam pratipadyate. So opposed to this, nasti brahmeti manyate, there is no Brahman. What is all this Shastra? So you are talking about a non-existent entity. It's all, you know, some kind of brainwashing. It is some belief system. So like that, because they don't understand. Here we are not talking about belief. Here is something that we are talking about you. And we don't have to believe. If when I say you are this, It's not a matter for belief. It's a matter for understanding. Without even attempting to understand, some may reject it, saying, okay, oh, I know I am this body, so why should I worry about your statement? So there are people, not that everybody is going to, you know, take this, because this Ishwara Anugraha Meva Kumsam Advaita Vasana. So Advaita, the smell itself is possible only because of Ishwara Prasada. Anugraha has to be there. Otherwise, not everybody is going to. Ascharyavat Pashyati Kaschidenam Ascharyavat Vadati Tataiva Chanyaha. Bhagavad Gita Bhagavan says, Ascharyavat Yenam Anyashrunoti Sutvapi Yenam Veda Nachaiva Kaschite. So, Ascharyavat Pashyati. So, only rarely somebody, someone out of crores of people even sees this fact. Out of them, Ascharyavacha Yenam Anyashrunoti. To others, only very few out of those who have learned, who have cognized this reality, comes and teach. Because, like I said in an earlier class, a jnani does not see a problem. Because even the suffering of others is only an as-though suffering. There is no real suffering because he or she knows everything is Brahman. So there is no inner pressure for a jnani to come and teach. But just as a kripa, some people will teach. Because from the standpoint of the person who is suffering, there is a suffering. Even though paramarthataha, there is no suffering. So when this person sees that, even the as-though suffering, so when I see an as-though snake on rope, I am still running from it. My fear is there. I should not step on it. Why take a risk? It looks like a snake. I run. I am afraid. Correct? So it may be an as-though snake for you. But to me, it's a real snake, because until the time I know it is a, it's a superimposition of the rope, it is a reality for me. My fear for me is real. That's how this jnani sees. So that person teaches. That's why Ascharyavacha Yenam Anyashrunoti Shrunoti Shutvabhi Yenam Veda Nachaiva Kaschidu. Only very few who listen to Shastra eventually also gets the same vision. Like that Bhagavan says in Bhagavad Gita. So that kind of a great asset is this. Niti, he tells Arjuna. So here, Nasti Brahma iti manyate. If somebody thinks there is no such Brahman and all that, Saha Sarvasya eva sanmargasya Varnasramadi Vyavastha Lakshanasya Asraddhadanataya Nastitvam Pratibadhyade. So this person then starts rejecting everything which is associated with it. Because Shastra says everything is Brahman and the moksha is the lakshya, is a marga, nivritti marga, so that one can gain Brahman. And even pravritti is towards that. So when you do a worldly thing, aligned to the dharma, aligned to your varna and ashrama, what you are supposed to do in a particular context. You are a brahmachari, this is what you should do. You are a grihastha, then you, this is what you should do. You are a grihastha, has to take care of not only his or her family, but also the brahmacharis. The person has to take care of the sannyasis. So because the whole life is centered around grihastha dharma, and that person is called upon to do certain duties, so do it without any, you know, attachment. Do it as a dharma. Like that Shastra tells. And this is vanaprastha. So you need to do these kind of dharma. This is sannyasa. Even there are two types of sannyasa: vidvat sannyasa and vividisha sannyasa. So there are certain niyamas which are told for sannyasis also. Even though finally for a jnani we say ko vidhi ko nishedaha, but you know, in the vividisha sannyasa, certain niyamas are told for sannyasa. So like that, the shastra has certain varnashrama, vyavastha. For this varna, a pot maker, this is how one has to act. And it is not about competing. It is about what can take you to Brahman. That's all it is. Each person, if one has to gain a jnanam, one has to create a conducive state of mind in oneself to gain this knowledge. So if that has to happen, depending on what state that, which context the person is born, that person has to act based on the situation, not attached to a particular worldly gain, but with gain of Brahman in context, a person does an action. So that is the lowest competition society is what our shastras try to advocate. That's why in those days it was a least competitive society. A person does not think about, you know, why I am doing this. So a brahmachari had a certain niyama. He cannot sleep on bed. He has to lie on floor. He should eat food which is from bhiksha. Go and beg for food and eat. Because one's ego doesn't come into picture. This is how Shastra asks one to live. Then person lives. He or she has to do Guru Seva. Learn from Guru. Whenever Guru wants to teach, he or she will teach. This person will learn, not on demand, right? Whenever it is given, the person takes it as a prasada. And then that's how a brahmachari life was. So there was no complaint. That's how it has to be. The person lives like that. There is no competition. Even women were like that. Men were like that. Everybody. So in different stages of life, one was used to, there is no complex, there is no competition. That's how the structure was. Right or wrong, that's how it was. And today's context has changed, but still we can take it as whatever one is called upon to do in a particular condition, that is like a varnashrama today, right? I am a doctor. This is my duty. This is my patient. I need to do this, not because of money or things that I am getting, but because I am called upon to do a particular action in a context. So I do it. My ultimate aim is to gain moksha, because this life is not about only procreation and eating food and all that and enjoying pleasures. But there is a purpose, because not everybody is endowed with faculties that a human has. Every animal, any animal or a bird or a plant which are also living, cannot gain this. Only humans can. Even amongst humans, not everybody has a situation, disposition, or ability to even listen these things. So I am endowed with all these things. It's a blessing. Therefore, I need to pursue this. With that attitude, when person does an action, that is Varnashramadi Vyavastha. That's how we have to take in today's context. Because otherwise this Varnashrama and all becomes an old thing now. Becomes very difficult now. Then we have to say, hey, you have to do your Varna Dharma and all that. Somebody's doing, that's okay. That's not what we are saying. We are not talking about completely going and changing a lifestyle and all that. If somebody wants to do a different lifestyle, that's a different thing. But it's not a mandatory thing for one to be in Sanmarga. But here, Pashikara, in his times, this was there. So that context is saying, because Varnashramadi Vyavastha is proposed by Shastra, he says, Vyavastha Lakshanasya Sanmargasya, that is Sadhu Marga. Paradharman Sadhyan, Paradharman Sadhnoti iti Sadhu. So the one who sees others' problem as one's own and helps is a sadhu. So that is general definition of sadhu. But here sadhu marga is for the great people. They need to follow that kind of a marga is sanmarga. That is varnashramadi vyavastha lakshanasya sanmargasya asraddhadanataya. without a shraddha innate, nastitvam pratipadyate. These kind of things are not needed. So even taking loan, you enjoy your life. Okay. Ranam grutva grutam pibet. Iti, this Charvaka says, there is only one shot at life. Just enjoy the life. Don't worry about all these things. There is no Svarga, there is no Brahman, there is nothing. So every day you just live your fullest. This is one way of looking at, right? So like that, there are many Nastitvavadis. There is nothing like all these pursuits. These people will say, there is any point of, in any age, there are people who say this also, correct? Nasti Brahma iti manyate, raha sarvasyaiva sanmargasya varnashramadi vyavastha lakshanasya asardadanataya nastitvam pradipadyate. Brahma pratipetti artatva tasya. Because these things, all this varnashramadi vyavastha is Brahma pratipetti artham. So because this person rejects Brahma pratipetti itself, then all this sanmarga also that person rejects. All this is not needed. Iti sashraddha is not there. Ataha nastikaha saha asan asaduhu uchyate loke. So asannevasa bhavati is the vakya in shastra. So Acharya takes the sat as asan, asat as asadhu. So here the sun, it is as though he or she is non-existent, is not what he says. He says here the sun has to be taken as asadhu. He is not a sadhu. So sadhu, we said, who is sadhu? So for the others, pain and suffering, one takes as oneself. Parakaryan sadhayati. Sadhnoti iti sadhu. So, I think I'll have to refer again. I read it somewhere. But anyway, so this, that is a sadhu. Here is asadhu. We all know who is sadhu. Yeah, a dharmika. Yeah, a simple person who is living a high-thinking life is a sadhu. So this is asadhu. When somebody is a nastika, that person is not willing to even understand, open up. We are not talking about a faith system or saying you believe in it, you will go to heaven, do kill the non-believer. That kind of thing is not what is spoken about. The Shastra is trying to look at the ashes situation and understand what is going on here, because our life is such a complex thing. We don't even know what is going on. If you think about it, there has been millions of years when you or I didn't exist. And there is going to be millions of years when we are not going to exist. This body has come in time, it is going to go away in time, and it has grown and it is going to perish. So we are talking about relations, money, wealth, possessions, all these things which we never had at one point. When we were born, we were born with nothing, not even a small thread on us. And when we go, we are not going to take away anything. So, and where did we come from? Where did we go? Do we survive beyond this particular body and life? We don't know. So, if I sleep, is there a guarantee I wake up tomorrow? No, there is nothing. We are here in this moment. So, whether we will be there in the next moment is not in our hand. This is called life. So we don't know what is there, what is going on, what is life, what is existence, what is nothing. So, outside, once we get up from this class, we think everything is, there are things under our control. We are doing this, I am doing that. But are we in control of our own? Forget the other situations around us. Even this own body that I breathe, is it in my hand? So, we don't have answers. That's where Shastra is getting you that vision to see what is the reality, what else other than Shastra. Barrels is the solution to this, or something like this. Therefore, this is the kind of thing. So they're nasty. If somebody says nothing like this, it's all useless and all, who, the loss is for who? Mahati vinashtihi is what Shastra says. The loss is huge if we don't gain this. Because you may have earned crores and crores of money, but what use is it? It's going to make you live for 500 years? Even if you live 500 years, then what happens? After 500 years, you have to go. All this accumulation of wealth is for what? Therefore, nāstikaha asādhu ucchate. It's not a very sensible person. That is what is asadhu. Forget, you know, of helping others and all that. The person is not, if one gets to know at least in from others and has some insights into this is what being spoken about and still one rejects it, then that's not a very intelligent thing. Because not because of Shastra, for one's own self is what we are talking about. Tadviparitaha san yaha asti brahmeti chedveda saha tad brahma pratipatti hetum sanmargam varnashramadi vyavastha lakshanam shraddhadhanataya yatavat pratipadyate yasmat tataha tasmat santam sadhu margastam evam viduhu enam viduhu sadhavaha. Then he is talking about sadhu or a jnani here, says tadviparitasanne, in opposition to the one who doesn't believe in all these things, the nastika, the one in opposition to that person, the one who says asti brahme dike veda, the one who knows, one who recognizes the Brahman's existence, saha tad brahma pratipatti hetum, the brahma pratipatti hetu, what are the things which will help you gain that Brahman? Sanmargam, the sadmarga. That is, what is sanmarga? San, we have seen even in Tamil that Ramalinganar says sanmarga, samarasa sanmargam. So sadhumarga. What is sadhumarga? Varnashramadi vyavastha lakṣanam. That is what we today call as Hinduism. That is Shastra. So we don't have such religious thing. The one who follows this marga is a sanmarga. That's all. It doesn't matter Hindu or Muslim or Christian or whatever. That's all today's context. In those days, you see, Shaul Acharya looks at the world. For people who follow Sanmarga, people who don't follow Sanmarga, that's all. We are not talking about religion here. Even amongst these people who lived in the same, even in one family, there will be somebody who is following Sanmarga, somebody who won't follow Sanmarga, that's all. This is the Varnashramadi Vyavastha Lakshana given by Shastra. Somebody follows it because one wants to gain Brahman, one doesn't follow. That's all. There is nothing else. We are not talking any religious differences, all that here. Sanmargam, Varnashramadi Vyavastha Lakshanam. It is defined by Varnashramadi Vyavastha. Because when you say marga, a path, it has to have certain attributes. What kind of path? Then we have to say whatever Shastra says, that is the path. So what that is defined by Varnashrama Adi Vyavastha. Not just Varna and Ashrama and all other things which go with it. Told by Shastra. Like Smartha Karma. Shastra talks about Shrauta Karma, Smartha Karma, like Puja, etc. All these things are part of Sanmarga. That is also done for what? Not propitiating some gods, but for one's own prapatti. வர்ணாசிரமாதி வியவஸ்தா லக்ஷணம் ஸ்ரத்தாதானதையா பை ஹேவிங் தட் இஸ் வேர் ஸ்ரத்தா லைக் யூ கேன் டிரான்ஸ்லேட் ரஃப்லி அஸ் ஃபெய்த் ஆர் யூனோ சம் கமிட்மெண்ட் ஸ்ரத்தாதானதையா யதாவத் பிரதிபத்யதே யஸ்மாத் ததஹ தஸ்மாத் சந்தம். ஹியர் ஆல்சோ பாஷ்யகர டேக்ஸ் இஸ் சந்தமேனம் விதுஹு he exists is one sadhu margastham idi bhashyakara so he is in the sanmarga or sadhu marga so there he used the word sanmarga here he uses the term sadhu marga so that san is sadhu sadhu margastham yenam viduhu sadavah these people are seen as sadhu margastha by whom by the other sadhus isn't it normal people won't realize it recognize it only other sadhus will recognize hey this person is also a sadhu he is in the sanmarga he or she is going towards the pursuit of brahman therefore this person is doing all this pranashtamadi vyavastha he has faith in this so like that people will recognize the sadhus will recognize iti bhashyakara use the meaning தஸ்மாத் அஸ்தி தேவ பிரம்ம பிரதிபத்தவ்யம் இது வாக்கியார்த்தா. ஸோ வாட் டு வி கெயின் ஃப்ரம் திஸ் ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் உபனிஷத்? பாஷிகாரா கன்க்ளூட் சேயிங் பிரம்ம பிரதிபத்தி பிரம்மன் அஸ்தி தேவ பிரதிபத்தவ்யம் ஸோ இட் இஸ் இன் யுவர் பெனிஃபிட் தட் யூ ஆல்சோ பிரம்ம அஸ்தி டேக் த ரவுட் ஆஃப் த பிரம்ம அஸ்தி தட் இஸ் குட் is what he is saying. You can start with Brahmasti. Tasya isha eva sarira atma yav purvasya tasya purvasya vijnanamayasya yeshaha eva sarire vijnanamaye bavaha sarira atma. So this kind of ananda Brahma, the anandamaya kosha, is vijnanamayasya shariraha atma. For the vijnanamaya, this anandamaya is atma, is the indweller. Kosau yaha yayesha anandamaya, this anandamaya is shariraha for vijnanamaya. Samprati nasti ashanka nasti tve. Okay. So that anandamaya, there is no ashanka. Nobody will doubt, do I have anandamaya? Am I ananda? One knows one is ananda because the priyamoda, pramoda is there. I am happy, I am pleasantly disposed, I enjoy. He is known to everyone because every now and then we enjoy a few things. Therefore, ashanka nasti par anandamaya apoda sarva visheshatvat பிரம்மணா நாஸ்தித்வம் பிரதி ஆசங்கா யுக்தா. ஸோ ஆனந்தமயா இஸ் நாட் டவுட்டட் பட் த புச்சம் பிரம்ம ஒன்லி இஸ் டவுட்டட் வை அப்போட சர்வ விசேஷத்வாத் ஆல் தர் இஸ் இட் இஸ் ஆப்சண்ட் இட் இஸ் டிவாய்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் ஆட்ரிபியூட்ஸ் விசேஷனம் இஸ் ஆட்ரிபியூட் அப்போட இஸ் டிவாய்ட் ஆஃப் சர்வ விசேஷா ஆல் கைண்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஆட்ரிபியூட்ஸ் த்வாத் பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் இட் பிரம்மணா நாஸ்தித்வம் பிரதி ஆசங்கா யுக்தா. வி கிளியர்லி சா பிக் டிபேட் ஆன் டிஸ்கஷன் ஆன் தட் பிரம்மணா நாஸ்தித்வம் பிரதி ஆசங்கா யுக்தா இட் இஸ் டெனபிள் தட் திஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் அன் ஆசங்கா தேர் சர்வசாமான்யாச்ச பிரம்மணா. தென் ஹி இன்ட்ரடியூசஸ் திஸ் வேர்ட் சர்வசாமான்யா பிரம்மணா. த பிரம்மன் இஸ் காமன் வை ஆகாஷாத் வாயு வாயோர் அக்னி அக்னேர் ஆபா அத்ய பிருத்வி இட் வென்ட் ஆன் So Akasha only, all this is created. But from Atma there is Akasha, Akasha, from Akasha, Vayu, all that thing. And here also Brahma Puccham Pratishtha, Brahman supports Anandamaya. And it supports Vijnanamaya, it supports Manomaya, it supports Pranamaya, it supports Annamaya. So every Annamaya, Pranamaya, Vijnanamaya, Manomaya, Anandamaya also resolves into this Brahma Puccham. Whether the person believes in Shastra, does not believe in Shastra, whether it's a man or it's a woman or it's an animal or it's a plant or it's anything which is seen in the world, because everything is come from Atma, Akasha, Vayu, etc. Correct? All these attributes are born out of the Srishti. That's how the Shastra has started. It said Atmanaha Akasha Sambhutaha Akashadvayu. So everything every object has its root in Brahman. If that is the case, Brahman is Sarva Samam. It is Samam for all that exists. If it is Samam for all that exists, then the question comes, why should one know this Brahman? Because whether you know it or not, you are finally going to go back to that Brahman only. Avidwan also goes back to Brahman, Vidwan also goes back to Brahman. A jnani goes to Brahman, ajnani goes to Brahman. A human goes back to Brahman, an animal goes back to Brahman, a plant goes back to Brahman, all the things are also back to Brahman, because Brahman is Sarva Samam. So there is a possible question. Uta vidva namun lokam pretya kaschana gacchati. Avidvan, the person who hasn't gained this knowledge, where does that person go? Because you say Brahman is Sarva Samam. So Vidwan, I can understand, will go to Brahman. But Avidwan also will only go to Brahman. Or will he go somewhere else? Because Brahman is Sarva Samam, is the karanam for even Avidwan. Ajnani also is nothing but Brahman, whether one knows or not. So will that person also go to Brahman? Because you say Brahma with Brahma Bhavati, this one who has gained Brahman becomes Brahman, I understand. What about Avidwan? So you can't say you will go elsewhere, because everything is Sarva Samam Brahma. So that kind of a question is possible. Therefore, somebody asked that question to the Guru. Uta Avidwan Amun Lokam Pretya Kaschana Gacchati. This Gacchati is Pluta. We have to say three matra. Gacchati. It is said because it's a question mark. It's a Veda is Shrutam. It's called Shruti. It is only heard and it is chanted. It is not written down in those days. It's a oral tradition. So then how do you tell a question mark in Veda? You can't put a question mark. So you use what is called Pluta. Kaschana Gacchati is a question. So the student asks the question, where does that person go? Vidwan amum lokam pretya kaschit samashnuta ashnute. So where does a Vidwan go? Where does Avidwan go? Is there a difference between the two? That kind of a prashna bijam is there. There is a question which is there to understand what is the difference between a Brahmavid and Abrahmavid, Avidwan and Avidwan. What is the difference in where each one of them go? The question which is possible, the student raises that question. So we'll see what the Guru answers. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.